Okay, welcome everybody to this podcast slash video. I'm today with Natalie Fille, and she's a dream coach, dreamer. And today we want to explore the topic of dreaming and what is possible in there. So Natalie, maybe tell us a little bit about your story, your connection with dreaming. Just how you want to start.
Okay. That's a bit of a strange story because just like everybody, I always dreamed like a child and when I was adult, and I never did anything with my dreams because I only remember the nightmares, for example. And you know, when in my culture, and I think in your culture also, it's when you're having a bad dream, our parents said, "Oh, okay, go to sleep, and it's just a dream." And my story starts, why I became a dream teacher starts actually from about 3 years ago, when I was I quit my job. And I was looking for, okay, what do I want to do now in my life? And I gave myself an assignment to do kind of investigation, to look for things what's out of the ordinary. And the second day, it's really funny, I started dreaming very clearly, very lucid, very, very lucid. So, you know, I always like to write. And at that moment, I had more time for myself because I was in between jobs. So I made stories of my dreams, but they were really, really vivid. Yes, and that was actually the start. And then there was a cycle of everyday dreams. And I wrote the dreams out. I made stories of them. And that led me to the... I wanted to know more about the content of the dreams. What do they mean? And that's the way I discovered the dream teachers training. So yeah, that's how it started 3 years ago. And at this moment, I trust so much on my dreams that I don't do anything, I don't make any big decisions before I had some symbols or things in my dreams which I can connect to the daily life. So yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna come back to that later.
Yeah.
And what does a dream teacher do? Like, with what issues come people to you? What questions do they have, and how do you help them?
Yeah, the clients, or do you mean when I talk about when I tell people, oh, okay, I'm a dream teacher, I'm a dream coach, because there's a difference between them, between questions.
Yeah, with clients, like with people that come to you.
Okay, when people come to me, they there's something with you know, they have questions about life. Like they are in the middle of a kind of crisis, or things they want to know more about themselves. And I start with working on their dreams. But I also do, I think you will ask that later because you read the book of Robert. You can also work actively with your dreams. So you can also dream when you are awake like this. That's something else, you know, and that's what I use. I use the night dreams, but I also guide people into, we call it active dreaming. And then that's the method I help people with. So, for example, is it easier when I give an example?
Yeah, please. Yeah.
Okay. For example, people who want to switch jobs. And then we have a little question, or people have some issue with their boss. It's also, that's something which came up to me. We talk a little, because, you know, I told you I'm a coach, and we talk a little, and then I say, okay, let's work with the active dreaming. And then I start this, do you know shamanic journeying?
I've done it once.
Okay, it's like it's almost similar to shamanic journeying, because then I say, okay, what's your question? And then I take them on a journey inside of them, with guided by drums and music. I do it like this, huh? On the new way. And then I ask, okay, what's your question? The important thing is, what's your question? And then they are going to travel inside. This is also kind of dreaming. It's very lucid dreaming. And then the people open themselves up to receive symbols, stories. And with what the story, what unfolds in this journey from about 10 minutes, that's what I work with the people. And it's very, the source is different, because the source is not your mind, but the source is, yeah, that's something we can discuss about, because the...
it's unclear, no?
Yeah, that's unclear.
But okay. And how do you then work with people? Because I've also read in the books that you can play like dream theater even to engage the energy of the dream.
Yeah. Yeah, that's also very good, because when you have an I connected. When you have an idea in your head, for example, you want to start something, then you also have to make it into this world. You know, give in Holland we say give hands and feet to it. I don't know what's it in German. Mm-hmm. Okay. So you get it out of you bring it into this world. And dream theater is also a way to play out things from the dreams. And so you make a theater of it, of the dream. And this energy can release, comes into this world. And it's very different when you do a dream theater. It can be done in many ways.
Can you give one example? Because I'm thinking about improvisational theater, or it's done by one person alone or more persons.
No, that is when we work with groups, because you need you can do it with wooden dolls, for example, or Playmobil. But it's for the energy, it's better to work with people, because you need trees. You know, you have a dream, and what is in your dream? Okay, that trees. Okay, who is the tree? Mm-hmm. So, okay, who's the goddess? So, and then there are all kinds of volunteers, and together you make this theater. So you bring the dream alive.
And then someone could say, like, the goddess is talking with the tree, or what can happen?
Yeah, but actually what you do is very simple. You have the dream. For example, you have a dream and you tell the dream, and then we say, okay, we're going to make a theater of it. Mm-hmm. And so literally what you have seen in your dreams, it will be play out in real.
And what do people get out of this dream theater? Like, how do they benefit from it?
It brings them peace of mind, you know, rest inside. Because when you have seen something, and you know, you can look around and see, okay, it's peace of mind, but also it's giving you some more clarity. What was happening, and you can also discover new things which you didn't see in the dream. But now when you are playing it out, it's so obvious that you are saying, oh, I really missed the message from the dream. And now, but it can be done in so many ways.
But then suddenly like the dream makes more sense to us.
Also.
Maybe.
Mm-hmm. Also. And it can be healing because you are healing for the soul or for the mind, for the person itself, because you see it, you can watch it, you can sit with it. It's you know, actually it's very difficult to explain in words what is happening, because you also sense it's the experience. You are inside literally in the dream.
It's like you travel to another place.
Also, yeah. And I think the experience itself, that is the benefits.
Mm-hmm.
For it, because the energy from the dream you experienced in the dream, but now it's playing out in very big with persons and mm-hmm. yeah.
Okay. And are there any like groups all over the world that are playing like dream theater, or it's more like a very like small portion of people that?
Now there are a lot of dream teachers, and they call it dream circles, and they are all over the world, because this I'm a student and a teacher from Robert Moss, the book you read, and we come from all over the world, so. Mm-hmm. Almost in every country, you can have a look on his site, because there you can find the teachers in the US, but there are also, you are from Germany, eh?
Yeah,
there are also teachers in Germany who do this.
Okay.
And also in Holland.
Okay, and you also run like a dream circle?
At this moment, because we are all at home.
Ah, okay. But in general, yes?
Yes. But I'm mostly working one-on-one with the people. And I, the dream circles is not that big here with me.
Yeah, okay. But it's something that would be interesting to grow, no? Like to have it more in the culture.
Yeah, but especially for families, for parents to work with the children and teach them all about the dream, the contents of the dream. Because, for example, I work with parents for children who are how do you say that in English? They want to be more self
centered.
Yeah, self-centered. And you know, the dream, because we didn't start with that, and that's really, really important to know. When you focus and connect your night dreams with your daily life, you become stronger. That's also what I experienced myself, because the power within, for example, you will rely on it, but it's an ongoing thing, and that's what we as children, at least I didn't learn, but the people from our ancestors, they they worked with the land, they worked with the dreams. I will start again. For parents, for example, when the children are scared or when they are having nightmares, it's very, very important to not wave it away. It's just a dream. It's very interesting to look at dreams and to look with another perspective on dreams and on nightmares. And in my trainings and in my coaching, when people have nightmares, I say, okay, that's good. Because that's really, because that's a reason to grow, to come closer to your core. Dreams or nightmares are calls from, that's from who, but it's from yourself. It's another part of you who is, I say another part, who is talking to you.
And what are different ways you can work with a nightmare? Like, let's say someone always has a nightmare and wants to do something for himself about it.
When people have nightmares, well, there are. I have a protocol. When you know, I don't know. Have you experienced nightmares?
Yes, but for me, they don't have so much emotional impact. Like, I don't. So not that I wake up and I'm still like terrified about it and like think about it the whole day.
No, okay. But when people, when you're really in a good nightmare, you're really scared at the moment. You wake up and a nightmare is most of the time a story in the night which has not been finished. But at the moment when you are really scared, I know it for myself, when my heart is here, I'm like this. It's most important to get the body to rest. So the breathing exercise is important. And then later on, it's difference for adults and children, because the adults, the parents have to teach their children. But now I'm talking for parents, for themselves. So calm your body. And there are many ways to calm your body. And then it's interesting to do research on your own nightmare. And it can be just to write it down, for example. And there's another method, but I would not advise that for people who are who have intense nightmares, to go back in the dream, because and then you can alter the dream. But that's a technique. You have to be advanced. So if you have real nightmares, I just wanted to say now to you, calm your body down. That's what people do, because there's a message for you in it. Mm-hmm. And when you are so afraid, or when you are calming down, is the most important, and writing it down the day after. What you also can do is after that is, what do I think the dream is telling me? And what is the positive thing from the dream now in my life? So you are going to ask yourself questions. And also what's important to write it down without judging it. And that's very difficult, because you are afraid and so write it down without judging it, and just let the dream be, let it be. So let it exist, because you are bringing the nightmare, also what I just told you about the dream theater, into this world. And then the dream is into this world. And then you can start a whole process for working with it. Again, I would not advise people it's not, oh, it's a new little method. It's really important to, how do I say, to do it with care.
Mm-hmm.
Am I clear about that or not?
I think what I can say from what I've read and understand, like sometimes, like you just don't want to jump back into the nightmare without any like help or guidance.
Sorry, can you repeat that?
That you don't want to jump back into the nightmare without any like being like grounded or have someone like helping you.
Yeah.
Who is more experienced?
Yeah. Yeah, that's correct. I help people with nightmares. That's my I like to work with the nightmares because there are a lot of energy in it for the people to grow and to solve issues in their lives. So I'm specialized in nightmares. You know, when you have done this once with a guide or someone who's experienced in working with dreams, then you can do it on yourself. But you know, when you're really, really scared, you're not jumping off a cliff without a parachute. Mm. It's like that.
Mm.
So I'm kind of the parachute mm. who helps you to glide easy.
Mm.
Or climbing a mountain without gear, you know? You're not climbing a mountain, the Mont Blanc, without training. It's like that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But when I work with people, I have a nice example. There was also a woman who, she had a real nightmare and she was afraid. And she came with me and said, okay, sit, we are going back into your nightmare. So I am with you. And then we made not a dream theater, but we created a new scene starting with safety. Okay, what do you need? What do you need? Protection? Do you need this? Do you need that? You know, you prepare yourself very good to be safe before you go into the nightmare. And then we went into the nightmare together and looking around again in the nightmare but now you're doing it consciously. So it's different and you can control it. We did that and the fear dropped a lot. And we went in and it dropped and it dropped and it dropped. And we were talking together. So yeah, together in a nightmare, you know, I'm a guide and I'm not afraid because it's not my nightmare. So I'm just looking around in the dream and okay. And then afterwards, when everything was, you know, settled, it was in balance. And we were also looking around and, you know, sometimes weird things happen. And I asked her, okay, I'm looking there. Do you see something? And she said, no, okay, we are walking together towards that place. And we entered something. And I have to tell you, we went onto a beach in the dream that was new. It appeared at that moment. And then she said, oh my gosh, that's my dream. And not literally the dream, but what it was a lost wish from her about something. So, you know, it can be, you can solve your fear, deal with your fear. This is a beautiful story, of course, but, you know, when you only can solve fear, it's amazing when you can do that. But this was a bonus because she solved the fear and then something else came up. So she started to change her life in that direction. So I'll never say a nightmare is something to suppress, but it's worth looking at it.
Mm-hmm. And you say as a teacher, you can join with someone together a dream, right? Like you...
Sorry?
You go with someone together into the dream.
Me?
Like, mm-hmm.
Yeah. As in. Yeah.
You, so it's like really like you both like two people kind of are like in the same dream in a way.
No, I have to explain this. This was, she had a nightmare. She came to me, mm-hmm. and she explained the nightmare, told the nightmare. And then we went back together to look again in the dream. That is what is active dreaming.
Mm.
You were talking about this. You told me about active. You read the book of active dreaming.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What active dreaming does? So you walk again with the dream.
Okay, but what I understand is also that sometimes, let's say someone is playing the drum, and then we have the person who had the dream that they want to know more about.
Yeah.
And then you can take someone else with you into the dream as like a guide who can also see new details.
Yeah, that is when that's also possible. That's another version of this. Mm. That is, for example, someone. Now I'm talking about dreams. Before, what I just told you before was about a nightmare. What you also can do when you work in a group or with more persons. Someone is telling a dream, for example, oh, I have this weird dream. I want to know more what's in it. I want to dive deeper in it. And then somebody is telling the dream, is framing, okay, this happened. And I want to know more. I have a few questions. I want to know A, B, or C, you know? And mostly two is good, because otherwise you have so many questions, you have to keep it in a little box. Anyway, then you have kind of trackers. That's what I think, that's what you mm-hmm. read.
Yeah.
Okay. So, for example, you have a dream about a lion. Yeah. And mm-hmm. the lion appeared in your dream and went to your house and blah, 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 blah. Okay. Anyway, you tell it. I'm a tracker, and there's another person who's also a tracker. Yeah. Then we ask the question, okay, what do you want to know? For example, we take this lion. Okay. I want to know why the lion is coming into my house. Yeah. And what's the message? Okay, it's clear, yeah. Okay, then you start. Then we start also on the drum, or you know, on music where you can change your state of mind. You dive into kind of, you know, on the drum, for example, yeah. Then we have a point where you decide. Okay, you are going to start in this particular part. And then we also go into this dream of you. And then we are going to look around. Okay, what is happening here? What do I see? Oh, okay, there are this, there's that. And then after a while, we come back. And then we make a report. We tell what we see. And then it's up to you. We just tell what we see, what is important for you, what you take out of it. Because I forgot to tell it, and that's a bit not good of me. But rule one, there's only one rule. You are always the owner of the dream.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning, I never say, I was in your dream, and it's telling you this and this and this. It is... I tell you, I was in your dream, and it's, if this is my dream, it is telling me this and this and this and this. So there's fundament?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Fundament of this work of active dreaming, because you are the owner. And you decide if it's working for you or if it's not working for you. Because dreams are made especially for you. So if I'm going to dive into your dream, my dream makers give me signs and symbols I can read. And sometimes it won't help you. But it's only telling me things. Okay, this is the symbol for love. Mm. This is the symbol for this. But so it's working together and finding out, okay, is it helpful for me? It's always meant to be helpful to lift somebody else up, to bring them, rest inside, more insights. It's growing to be, to be more of you.
Mm.
Yeah.
So we have some people like dreaming for you, and you see what you want to take of their experience.
Yeah, absolutely. That is so important, that is so important. It's not somebody else outside of you is telling you what's good of you. No, it's telling I'm telling my experience, and you take from my experience what's helping you. It's always to raise your vibration and your energy. It's never meant to be to lower your energy. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And that's the beauty of this work of active dreaming.
Mm-hmm. Because in when we look back into psychoanalysis or other things, often you have the expert that then tells you this symbol means that, and
that's what I mean. You are the expert. I'm not the expert on it. You are the expert. And that's also why I like it, because there's not somebody who's telling you, okay, oh, when you see a lion, it means I have another example. And that's with the dream encyclopedia, dream, the dream,
yeah.
Dictionary. I don't know how you the word in English. Anyway, a friend of mine, she's also a good dreamer. She's also a dream teacher. And sometimes, of course, I also use the internet because, I will come back to that later. For example, the dream, when you see a spider in your dream, or spider eggs, and you see, she had this, she saw spider eggs in the dream. And for her, a spider is a creature which is a kind of totem animal. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? It's a power animal for her.
Mm-hmm.
Because a spider is for her connected to creativity, weaves webs, and it's very creative. And she saw in a dream, she saw spider eggs. And she was thinking, okay. And at that moment, she didn't have a direct recollection of the meaning of it, because you always ask yourself, what is it? What represents the symbol to me?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then she put on, she opened a dream dictionary on the internet.
Yeah.
And there was a story. Oh, when you see spider eggs, it's worse, and your life is not on the right track, and this and that. And then she called me and she said, okay, do you want to work with me with the dream? Because we do that. Do you want to work with me with the dream? And she said, okay, I saw these spider eggs and blah, 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 blah. And I said, oh, spider eggs. Oh, that's amazing, because there's a lot of creativity waiting to come to life. And she said, oh my gosh, yeah. Oh, I forgot. She's a teacher, right? I forgot it. She said, yeah, I was looking into the web and they were telling this horrible stories. So, and I said, okay, for me, it means creativity. I don't know if that's also the meaning for you. Oh yes, yes, of course. So, she is the expert on it. So yeah. I always say, look for your in your own dictionary, because you're going, when you work with your dreams daily, you are going to build your own dream dictionary. And sometimes when you're curious or you think, I want to know more about this, then you can look into the dream dictionary on the internet. But always remember, you are the expert on it.
Mm-hmm. And you already started to get into the dream journal. I think it's a really important piece of the puzzle, right?
Yeah. Robert, the teacher says, and he's a writer. He has written many books about dreaming. And now after 3.5 years writing daily, I write about 1,000 pages a year for myself. I do reports, but okay, you know, I'm also a teacher, so... But after 3 years, I can say, he's saying, there will be no more important book in your life you will write than your dream journal.
Mm.
And now at this moment, I can say, yeah, you're right. Because when you write your dreams down, there are so much in it. You're making your own symbols. You're what's a lie. Lying for you, what's it? Why am I talking about lies? I don't know. Anyway, but you know, there's so much in it, and you discover more about yourself, about the world around you. It's endless. So you can use it in the way you want, the dream journal. It's important, and I also know my clients. I say, okay, write them down, but I also know we all have jobs. You know, you cannot sit in the morning and write for half an hour. It's difficult. So I say, okay, maybe you can do it in the weekend. Or, you know, we all have these modern devices. You can record it, the main issues, and write it out later. There's so many ways. But the journal, yes, it's amazing to work with the journal. And you can also do, for example, little trainings. And then you work with the group. That's also another thing. Then you do it for a little period of time.
What is that?
Well, in the dream circles, for example.
Mm-hmm.
When you join a dream circle. But, you know, I'm very practical. And I always say, okay, what's the... easiest way to work with your dreams. So take little notes and write it down, or just make speak with yourself, and you say, okay, I write my dreams down on Saturday or on Sunday. That's what I do. You know, the dream. You also have to instruct the dream makers, because otherwise you get an overload on information.
And how do you instruct the dream makers, or how do you talk with them?
Okay, no, that's very easy. I have notebook on my next to my bed. But for example, when I want to know something, more clarity on an issue, I question. I want to know more about blah, 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 Project X. So, you know, you write down an intention.
Yes.
And then you surrender to the... and trust that the information will come. But that's a process. That's for me, it was a process to rely on the information I get, because I'm very mental, trained. I come from the business area. So, and they say, yeah, trust your dreams. No, I trust my own mind. So, but when you get proof during everything goes along, and then you get proof, and then you get something in your dreams, and then later on you apply it in your life and it's working, then it's interesting. It's a nice play.
And dreams also, so what was for me really powerful, because I restarted doing a dream journal like 10 days ago, I think.
Yeah.
And then I already had like a dream about a friend, and we were like in the dark in the theater.
Yeah.
And that was it. It was not so big. But then some days later, I was talking to this friend, and I read about in Robert's book that you can grow a dream for another person.
Also?
Like the person can give you a scene, and then you, from there, you see what your imagination and dream comes up with to also follow intention or something. And then the scene this friend gave to me was like in just in a dark theater. Yeah. And she tells me this, and then I was like, wow, I just dreamt about this like 3 days ago with you. So, and this was for me like another sign that, wow, it's super powerful. It's like,
yeah,
that dreams can go into the future. And what I've read is like, it's very common, no? That dreams can have very visionary states.
Absolutely. And it's so interesting what you're saying, because you are in a theater. You know, it's also the wordplay in it. And I just say, when you are being called, because you had the intention, okay, now I'm starting with the journal. And then the dream makes say, oh, finally, there's somebody we can play with. But I explain it when I give lectures. I use the equation with Harry Potter, who's the first scene. Oh, you know what scene I'm meaning?
No, but I just made a video about Harry Potter in on YouTube. That's why I'm laughing. Of the
oh, that's so funny. You know the scene with Harry Potter. It's the first. It's almost the first scene when he gets this letter. And the father is throwing it away, and in that scene all the owls are the house is bombed with all these letters. He has to go to Schweinstein. It's in Dutch, it's Schweinstein. Anyway, I don't know the word maakt niet uit. Anyway, a dream is like a letter. But when you're not when you don't open it, yeah, they are writing. Okay, well, we just sent the same letter. Oh, okay, well, they are sitting like this. Yeah, nobody's watching our movie. So or he is not watching our movie. So when we connect to the, symbol, huh? But when we connect to it. Yeah, okay, now we can work, because he's listening. He's paying attention to it.
So, So we're talking, like having a dialogue and like a game, a play with our, like the guys who make our dreams, like our guides or whatever.
Whatever, you know, why don't I say, you know, for me, it has to be, it's not this or no. Nobody knows who's making the dreams. You know, we all have this research, and people saying it's meaning this and it's meaning that. And I know they don't know. And for me, it's important. Is it working? What can I do with it? How can I apply it into my daily life? How it's going to make my life easier, better? That's how I don't know who the dream makes, and I think nobody makes. And I think there are guides, there are your higher self, your soul, whatever. But it's important. But what you say, you can have these dreams when you are open to it and you're writing in your journal, it's fun. It will be fun.
Yeah, yeah, that's what I also saw. And another interesting thing that I read, and I think it's also interesting now because people cannot go out. Or let's say we have like two lovers on different continents. So what I've read, you can also make like a date in a dream, so you can join the same dream, maybe.
Yeah, that's possible, but I have not managed that. You know, when you go to sleep and then meet somebody, I know people can, I can't. So I can tell you something about it, but, you know, I have not experienced this. Yeah. You know what you're saying? So if you get a date on this level, in the dream state, for me, I'm not able to do that. So... there are people who can do it, and I know you can train it, but that's not my my business. You know, sometimes I meet people. I know what you're saying. Oh, I dreamed about you, and they are appearing into my life, or you get a phone call, or whatever. But a dream date, as you say, yeah. And you have to ask somebody else, but I cannot answer that question.
Okay, but it's possible, right?
Like people, I know people did it.
Because I think that's just important to have stories for people that it's actually possible. Because sometimes when we see like, oh wow, someone can do it, then I can probably also do it.
Yeah.
At one point.
Yeah. But my question would be, if you have the internet, just like we are having now, why make it difficult and meet in the dream state?
Because I think the experience would be more, it's different, no? Like than talking with someone here on the screen or share a dream together. It's like more magical.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I know what you mean.
And what else I want to say, because there's also like lucid dreaming and how I understand there's a bit of a difference to active dreaming, because many people do like many practice. So to wake up in a dream and realize like, oh, I'm dreaming right now. Can you say something to this, if you also practice this, like waking up in a dream, or you just like remember it in the morning, or how is it?
There are also I looked into it because there are a different explanations for lucid dreaming. I know I dream very vivid, clear. And sometimes I know I'm dreaming. And do you know the test when you want to wake up in the dream? That's a very test.
Tell them. I think I know some, but it's good if you...
Okay. Sometimes you wake up in a dream and then you are lucid. I'm also training this, because sometimes I get so excited and then I wake up in a dream and then, oh, I'm dreaming. And when I'm dreaming, the first thing I want to do is want to fly. I don't know what it is. A lot of people, I know there are few things. People want to fly and people are going to have sex with somebody else. That are the two most important things when they get lucid. Okay, I always want to fly, but you have to become aware that you are dreaming. And there's a test. There's a simple one. There are a lot of tests, but there's a simple test. And one of the tests is looking at your hands like this and like this. To train that, you can also train it during the day. Because when you're dreaming, your dream self, it's very difficult to reproduce your hands. So your hands will look different. I have, when I do that, I miss fingers, or I have very long fingers, or I have fingers like a witch or a hag, something like that. And then I know I'm dreaming. And then the first thing I do, okay, I can fly now. So I start flying. But the thing is, when you get lucid in the dream, I know a lot of people get excited. And because you get excited, you wake up.
Mm.
So it's also a training to stay calm.
Mm-hmm. How you make that? How you stay calm?
Yeah, it's like, okay, turn around. Then you and another thing to stay calm is, okay, I know I'm going to be at this, so you have to train your mind in the dream. Okay, I know I'm getting excited, so I have to switch and to another scene. So you can turn to your left or turn to your right, so you have to look to something else. So you have to change your attention to another thing.
Mm.
But for me, it's very difficult. But lucid dreaming is about getting waking up in the dream.
Mm-hmm.
And the most people who are lucid dreaming, you know, it's most lucid you are in the morning before you wake up. But there are a lot of interpretation about lucid dreaming.
Okay, so it's not clear, or like,
no, it's what you understand with it, because this active dreaming, you are also awake, but you combine it with daily life.
Yeah,
because this shamanic journeys, for example, is also a kind of lucid dreaming.
Mm. True.
It's like a switch in your mind when you put out the button, I'm going to be in control. It's in the shamanic dreaming. Then, in the shamanic journeys, you surrender to the, it's like becoming in a state of relaxation and open to receive all the images what wants to come to you. And that's kind of, for me, it's kind of lucid. Dreaming also, it's very connected to each other.
Okay, yeah, I think, yeah, one difference is probably what I see more is the classical explanation of lucid dreaming, that you wake up and then you can do what you want, right? Like flying or building something, that you kind of like take more control of the the dream.
That's indeed the classical explanation, and that's also the how I call it, the ego mind.
Mm.
Because in the dream state, when you're dreaming, you are not in control.
Mm.
And then you want also have control in the dream state. But how beautiful is it when you can surrender to what the universe or whatever, the guides or who is bringing to you,
mm-hmm.
instead of rushing, oh, I want to see person B, how he's sleeping. Okay.
Mm.
Yeah. And when you surrender to, okay, what's the best, what is it I have to know right now? That when you ask a question, then you are in another state of, then you are another state. Then your ego is, I'm not saying ego is bad, but then you are not in control. Then you are receiving what you need to grow to your, more to your core.
Yeah. Or you're getting different answers, or like different point of view for your problem.
Yeah, different point of view. Yeah. That's absolutely, you get... that's why your dreams are also interesting, because when you have something to deal with, the dream makers will never give you cannot handle.
Mm.
So, and you will always get they are fun. It's really fun. And you always get something, they know you the best.
Mm.
So they will never step on your toes. for example. You know, you will get it in a smooth way, in a, you know, like a mother for a child, you know, that kind of unconditional love. And sometimes you need a little spank, but it's always done with a kind of love. And I know a lot of people are saying, oh, I dream this and I dream that, and it was really horrible. But that's just an invitation for me. I would say, see it as an invitation, and see it if dreams are always made for you to support you. And if you look at dreams from that point of view, you can also look differently to the information or to the dream itself.
Yeah.
So when I, you know, when I'm having, I still have nightmares, and, you know, I get up and I'm in fear, and then when I'm relaxed, I say, oh, I'm having a nightmare. It's now something to grow. But in the moment when I'm having this nightmare, and in the moment when I wake up, you know, I'm also not happy with it. So I have to calm down, and in the morning when it's light and there are not a lot of things, you know, I'm settled back, then I can look at it with another eyes, because now I really know and I really trust it's always to support me. That's for me, it was a process. Other people can apply it easier, but for me it was a little process. But you know, you also had this dream where you were thinking, oh, how fun is this, and oh, that's curious, my friend, I told her with her, and now it's playing out.
Yeah. It just shows you the power, no, and like,
yeah,
that there is something else going on that we don't see and don't know exactly about. One more question, what I found is important. If someone does not dream, like if someone is not in touch with his dreams, like either at night, but also has no, like, you know, like vision or dream for his life in a way, like how can you work with that?
Yeah, a lot of people, the first thing when I meet people is say, I don't dream. And indeed, there are people who don't dream, but mostly it's, they are meaning I cannot remember my dreams. And to start your, remember your dreams again, is to, you can do a few things. One is to, when you go to bed, I told you about the notebook next to my bed. You write down, this night I will remember my dreams. And, you know, it's, maybe it's not starting, because there can be a lot of things. But when you do this every night, this process, it's like learning a new skill again. This night I will remember my dreams. And you know, when it's not starting, we get frustrated. But there's one thing you can do when you wake up in the morning. You just wait, because dreams are like mist. They are gone very rapidly. So you just wait, and you know, you read the instruction how you can remember your dreams. Just wait. If there's something coming back, and you know, also a thing, don't start with the head, but start with the tail. So you're like a fish, you're going to come back. So you start at the end. So, and then you can pull back your dream. And also, when there are still no recollection of dreams, then you have to make something up. That is the thing, because it's, you have to grow this, and then you make so, oh, I dreamed that. It's not true, but you make something up, and then you're showing it's a method, eh? It's not, but then you're showing to yourself and to your dream makers, okay, I'm open to receive dreams. And then you make something up and you're going to play with it. And it can be a little short thing. And then it can grow.
So you're sending out the message kind of like, I'm willing to play.
Yeah.
To the dream makers.
Yeah, I'm willing to play. And when it's not happening, there can be, I know a story of also a person who had such a nightmare when she was young. And she decided back then, I will never remember my dreams again. You know, because there's also, that's another, maybe we can talk about that another time. But there are also encounters in dreams with whoever, whatever. And sometimes when it happens to children, they block it. Mm-hmm. And then you have to go to an expert to you can open that again and you have to work with it. But then dreams can also come back. Because the people who come in the training from Robert and us, they start dreaming after a while. But it's kind of training.
Mm-hmm. What I also saw, like with the dream journal, like sometimes I think I don't really remember. I only remember one tiny thing. And the moment I take my pen and like put it down to write something, then like new things suddenly like pop up and like, wow, yeah, of course.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's just the moment you make the decision and do the action.
Yeah.
This also then helps you. No, in a way.
Yeah, also when you take the pen and you write down something, and or when you go to the shower and then something pops up again, you know, it's kind of aiming your energy also for receiving and recall the dream energy. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But it's I think, I don't know if it's true, that you have to you open yourself for receiving the dreams, and you know, and don't make a big issue of it if it's not coming directly, because it will come, and take it easy, and just what you were saying, just play. It's all about the play, and it's about raising your energy. Yeah, but it can bring you a lot of it can change your life. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I think so. Should we talk about something else? Does something else come to your mind? Something that you think is really important for people to know regarding like dreams and waking life or like...
Let me think.
What I found really interesting, like in history, like dreams, that like how much like dreams shaped our history.
Yeah.
That I think like Albert Einstein.
Yeah.
Like his kind, like theory of relativity was based on a dream, no? Like he was working on this one dream, like chewing on it for years to make sense of it, to then be led to his biggest scientific breakthrough.
But most things come to you at dreams. Indeed, Albert Einstein, but you know, also the man of, I don't know his name at this moment, of Google, who made Google one of the two. Mm-hmm. He was, when he was younger, he was also pondering about something. He dreamed also in a symbolic way. Huh? It's often symbolic, because Einstein, he saw himself gliding off a hill. And that's when he found on this relativity theory. This man of Google, I don't know his name, he also dreamed, he was looking for how to, I don't know, I'm not a computer person, but something that was also one of the starts of Google. And do you like these examples?
Yes.
It's so funny. The chewing, chewing is chewing when you make clothes.
Sewing.
Oh, sewing. I was saying chewing machine. Sewing. The sewing machine was the man who discovered it. He, in his dream, I always use this example because I like it. He was dreaming, he was hunted by people with these big arrows. And then he saw a hole in it, in the arrow. And that was the start of the sewing machine. Mm-hmm. This song of the Beatles. They also receive music in their dreams. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, there are a lot of examples.
Many examples, yeah. Right?
And also often in Dutch, it's benzeen. It's the.
Yeah, like this ring.
This ring. Yeah. He was also dreaming about this. He saw it also in the dream, the solution for it. Yeah, there's so many what comes to you in dreams. So now I was also saying, okay, let's dream that for the time frame we are in now with this pandemic.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
I say, okay, let the dream come to the people who have to find the solution for it. Because then they can dream. And they dream the solution or the thing which can solve this virus.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But I don't know if it's done yet.
But you also said people have now like different dreams, right? In the quarantine and with the whole virus thing going on. There's like something changing in the dream landscape of people.
People, what I've heard, and it makes sense to me, is that people are dreaming more now. Why? Because a lot of people have more fears expressed in their dreams. And it's logical, because when you open a newspaper, you only see the fear news. So I know there are a lot of dreams about floods, about being chased, about being little ants, bugs. So that is happening. And people are confronted with life. It isn't endless. And also when you look around.
Mm.
So that's also a lot of another story maybe that what's interesting to tell. At the beginning of the year, in our dream, the dreamers, you can dream the future.
Mm-hmm.
What is unfolding this year, for example. And I know there are a lot of people from my group dreamed about cleaning. And I will share you for my own dream, because then you can see dreams are about laughing also. Because I don't want to know what's going to happen in the future, because I'm thinking, oh, no, I don't want to know. But anyway, I had a lot of dreams about toilets. Mm-hmm. And about cleaning, about cleaning, and I was thinking, oh, this is strange. Why do I dream about a toilet? And about, I had also at the beginning of the year a dream about at the hairdresser, going to the hairdresser, mm-hmm. and there was something going on there. But I don't know if it's in Germany so, but in Holland, the hair dressers are not allowed to open. So now in these days, you see people with men with hair, and it's not, you know, all the hair is strange. So yeah, so the dreams can be like this.
Mm.
A lot of people dreamed about cleaning, and this is also kind of cleaning period.
Right.
What we are in. So it doesn't have to be fearful.
Mm-hmm. And everyone is talking about washing their hands.
Yeah. Yeah, overal. Yeah. And yeah, so yeah. So you can dream the future also.
And you can also sometimes, what I figured, like, you have to act sometimes on your dream so you can change the future, right?
Yeah. Do you have an example?
Not for myself, just what I read in Robert's book. Yeah. Like, sometimes the people dream like a scene, you know, like their child is like, they go with them camping, and then they suddenly found them like floating on the water, like drowned.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And they went somewhere else to do dishes at the camping ground.
Mm-hmm.
And then, like, they are in reality there. And they don't remember anything. They do their camping thing and then go to clean the dishes. And their child is playing somewhere. And then once they walk up, like, suddenly, like, the whole dream flashes back into their mind.
Yeah.
Like, what they dreamed, and they saw their child floating, and then they act on the dream and change the outcome.
That is also happening. I have to say, I don't have a lot of experiences with that, because a lot of people who are thinking, okay, I'm going to dream this, they get scared. But what you also can do is, when you have this this dream, or this is kind of a wake up, okay, this is what I dream, so I have to go on to that now. But when you dream this before, for example, 1 week or 2 weeks before, and you get scared of it, you can also then, what I was talking about with you earlier, re-enter the dream, mm-hmm. and then change it at that moment. So you don't have to go to the campsite. Do you know what I mean? You change it in mm-hmm. the moment. Sometimes I do that. When I, for example, I have dreamed something, and then I was, this was not... You know, with family, yeah. This is not okay. So then I go back in the dream, and then I'm changing it.
Mm.
But and then that can also be possible to change it.
And how do you go exactly back into the dream? If you can tell it again.
Okay. Like what we said before, you decide, for example, you have to be calm and relaxed. That's, mm-hmm. that's number one. Don't go back in the dream with fear. Yeah. And you can also go back in nice dreams, by the way. And you decide before you go, okay, why do I want to go back in the dream? So you set an intention. And this is what I'm going to do. For example, now you want to change the outcome. You're trying to change the outcome. And then you put on your earplugs, you put on the drum, and then you start at a specific point where you ended in the dream. You walk around in the dream what you want to change, you change it, and you the exit is also the starting point. That's also important. So where you start, you also go out of it.
And how do you start, or how do you know what is your starting point?
You decide that for yourself.
Okay. Like a scene, like a picture.
Yeah, you have a dream, huh? You had a dream from A to Z. And then you say, okay, Z was not that where I want. What do you want to do? So you make for yourself up what you want mm-hmm. to do in the dream before you start.
And
then you pick a point X or B. That's where you mm-hmm. start, and then you go do your thing,
mm-hmm.
and then you go out again there.
Okay.
Go back, as we say.
You go on a dream mission, kind of.
Yeah.
Like
Mission Possible. Mission Possible.
Wow. I mean, it's very, like, a lot of, like, action, no? Like, active dreaming, like,
you really... Yeah, this active dreaming. You can get out of it a lot, because you also can start your own, what I'm at this moment developing inner travels, because people cannot travel around, to do journeys. I guide them a bit. So first I take you to a cinema. Mm-hmm. Well, for a cinema, for example, a cinema of possibilities.
Mm-hmm.
So then I talk to you like we are talking like this, and then you hear my voice, and I guide you into the cinema, and I say, oh, look at your right and look at your left, and you know, so you're to get the imagination muscle mm-hmm. On. So then it's on, and your mind is relaxed, and your brain waves are in a specific modus, and then the music starts, and then you're going on a travel, and in the end, and then this whole journey unfolds, and you're just the the watcher, the
observer,
yeah, the observer, and then you come back with this information, and then you can do a few things. One, oh, this was a nice experience, because you can experience what you said, a dream date. But you can take in all the information. What I do is write it down or tell it, and then work with it, because there's so much information in these travels for your life. It's really helping you forward, and it's not coming from your mind. It's coming from another source. And that's the beauty of it. And it's fun. It's really fun.
Do you have one more tool for working with it besides dream theater, or how we can work with the dream?
When you can also, but then you need, for example, two persons or three, at least two. It's also a nice game. You write down a question. I want to know and you can ask any question you want. Yeah, that is one. You write it down on a little card. Yeah, and then you play the drum or you relax, and anyway you have to come into another state, and then you are recalling a dream. What wants to come up now? Then the question is, what wants to come up now? What is dream or memory? It doesn't matter. Mm. What comes up, you write it on a paper. And then you do a dream swap. So when you are with two, you can just swap it to you. But when you're with four, then you put a number on it, and then you swap the things. So, and that is the answer to your question.
From the other person.
Yeah.
Ah.
That's also nice.
Ah, wow. That's nice, interesting.
So when you are with friends, when in Holland we are allowed, I don't know now at the moment, four or five, but when you are with five friends, that's a nice play. Something else than drink a beer. Or maybe you do it with joy, and I don't say you have, you know, you have to be in a relaxed state, and oh, what shall we do, that's nice, and you can really do it with important questions or issues you have.
Wow, that's
it's amazing.
So you can do dream evenings together.
Dream evening, yeah. Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's so many possibilities, right? Like, it has so many different, like, perspectives to it. Like,
yeah.
What you can do.
And the important thing that you do it with joy. And, you know, it's there's no good and there's no bad. It's just, oh, this is a funny point of view, because you know why this is also so powerful. You get out you put your your mind out of the way. Because you write an intention, you write a question, you want to know about love advice, for example. That's what a lot of people want to know, advice. And when I talk to you, I know, for when we are friends, I know you, I know when he's did, so I'm not going to say this. I know, you know. And then nobody knows your question. Then you see the drumming and you open up to whatever the universe or whatever. There comes a memory, there comes a dream, there comes something comes up. You are not in control from what comes up. So you're giving this this field of creativity, you're holding space for it. You write that down and you don't know for who the answer is. So, yeah.
Yeah, it gets a lot of like things out of the way, like blockages.
Yeah, wow,
it's really like a different life that can open up, right?
Yeah, it's so much fun. It's so much fun, yeah.
Wow. And what would you recommend, like a book that people can read that will also help them to get more familiar with the whole dreaming, and they don't want immediately like do it by themselves or go work with a dream teacher?
You have the book of wait, I was having it here. Can you pass me the book van Dromenbus? Sander, kun je me dat boek even geven van Dromenbus? I think you have this book, huh? Active Dreaming.
Yeah.
But it's a very thick.
I read it online. Like, I did not have it.
Oh, okay, okay. Well, it's a very big book, and he's very specific. And this is a good book for people, you know, who want to get familiar to it. But it's a big book. There's also another person who is, it's a smaller book, and he is also, I have not trained with him, but I have read his book. His name is Charlie Morley. Charlie Morley. And he has written, it's from Hay House, I don't know exactly. Charlie Morley, I will
You can give it to me and then I will just put it under the
you put it on
video.
Yeah, and that's also a good start. It's Robert's book, I recommend
his
one of
really
his teachers, but I can imagine if you want to have a little less it's also a good book of Charlie.
Okay, and if someone has like a nightmare, you're a really good specialist.
Yeah, they have to come to me. I can work on Zoom with them, so yeah.
Now, how can people reach you if they want to get in touch with you? Because I tried your website, I think it didn't work.
No.
That has like the German ending, the DE.
I have to change that. That doesn't work anymore. My website is nataliedreamsarl.com.
Okay.
And then you can write it. But it is in Dutch. But when you click for sending an email, that's in progress because I'm on the... And I have a YouTube channel also. I have one client of one...
You can give it to me and I just put it.
Oh, okay. But I don't. I think you have Dutch people, offer German or
international. I think.
Oh, international. Okay. Yeah, I will send you my my website and again, and I will. Okay.
Okay. Would you say you have one final sentence or words for people or?
About dreams. Dreams are your mirror. Dreams are a mirror. And you just have to have fun with them.
Mm.
Yeah. It's all about fun and play and make your life easier. Yeah, that's for me.
Okay. Wow. So thank you very much.
You're welcome.
For taking your time.
Yeah, I love to talk about dreams.
Yeah, it's a great topic.
Yeah.
And yeah, let's stay in touch.
Yeah.
And let's hope that more people take to dreams.
Yeah, absolutely.
Understand the significance that they can hold for their lives.
Yeah. Yeah. And I hope so. Spread the news about what dreams can do for you.
It's yeah. Amazing.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So, see you another time.
See you another time.
And thank you very much.
Thank you. Okay.
Okay, guys. This was our talk about dreaming. I hope you loved it. And if you liked it, click subscribe, follow my channel for more out-of-the-box interviews, content, and see you soon. Thank you for listening and watching. Bye-bye.